watch your videos.
Oh, good.
It's very nice. This is very good.
I'm so glad. That's pretty special. I was pretty much born a yogi, but there wasn't yoga when I was born in America. But I found it when I was 18, when I was in college, and I found that there was this way that I could connect to higher realms, and I started to really investigate it, I guess, and practice hatha yoga at the time. And I went to school up in Ithaca, New York, which is a pretty open-minded area. So there was a lot of yoga available, a lot of work on chakras and new age information. So I got involved then, and that was the beginning of a long, many years of yoga, really.
Nice. So, definitely. Actually, and the success of Kundalini Yoga, in my opinion, clearly it is related to our practical way of seeking. And through the proper practice, how to wake up the energy and guide the energy. So it is guiding by the Shiva. Shiva means it is witnessing pure awareness. It is talking in Christianity, it is Father consciousness. No? Okay. So the Kundalini is actually the Holy Spirit, maybe. So this Kundalini is the basic energy of the all. The creation of all universe. Actually, it is more related to practical experience of the life and the life experiences. Kundalini have two phases. One is going to outer world through the Ajna Chakra to outside for manifestation. One is the Sushumna path through the Swadhisthana to go to above the chakras and go to Samadhi of the Sahasrara. So one is out phase, second is in phase. To go out phase, you cannot go to in phase, go inside path. That is calling the nadi is Brahma nadi. The Sushumna path is calling Brahma nadi in Shakchakra Nirupana. So in Sividya, it is handling material life and the spiritual life. The success of material life and spiritual life. Yeah, simultaneously it is handling. That is the speciality of Sividya. Normally, in ancient time in India, especially Kerala, the kings were using the Srividya to enlighten at a time. So,
wait,
it is very contradictory.
Can you say that one more time? So, the kings were what? And was it because it was so powerful?
Because they have to fight to other kings. Fight against with other kings, and they have to go to Mukti also, Samadhi also. Okay. They need. They have to at a time. They have to handle the both phase of the life, out phase and in phase. At a time, they have to manage. They have to do. No way. So
was
they,
it no? I have a really important. I have a very important question that I really would love to know the answer to. Was it a secret? Was it a secret that only the kings knew back then?
Sorry? Was?
Was it a secret? Was it a secret?
Yeah, yeah, it is still the secret tradition.
And it's still secret. It's still
but
secret.
Very old. But very old. Because it is very old system.
How old?
We cannot say like that. We cannot, because it is very old system. Pre-Vedic, because research is going on that. Yeah, from Pre-Vedic. The research is going. So many contradictory things are coming. So we cannot exactly say that.
But is it over 1,000 years old?
Ah, definitely. So actually, what is the speciality of Sri Vidya? So normally, if you go through the yoga, I am also a yoga teacher of Ashtanga Yoga and Zen Buddhism and Sufism. Everything I am handling, but I am preferring to teach people the Kundalini, the Sri Vidya is to, because the reason is at a time it is handling both phase of the life, because the people, normal people, have the desire. If you go through the yoga, what is happening means some people have that capacity to go through that yogic level, like you people. We can control our desire and we can handle the desire properly. Then we can go to inside Sushumna path. But most of the people, normal people, common people, they have desire. Desire is outfaced through the Ida and Pingala, through Ajna to outside. Ida Nadi and Pingala Nadi, Surya Nadi and Chandra Nadi. It is manifesting the Kundalini through the Ida and Pingala and through the Ajna to outside. They are trying to the law of attraction. They are working on that and doing the things for fulfill their desire located in Swadhisthana Chakra. Okay? The desire is a main block which is located in the Swadhisthana Chakra. That's why when the Kundalini is rising and it is coming to hitting that block of the desire, and it is splitting as two and coming through the Ida and Pingala through Ajna to outside. It cannot go to some people have I cleared many cases, psychological issues like some kind of dissociative identity disorder, some anxiety disorders, this kind of issues are showing by some yoga practicing people. That is not the problem of yoga. Actually, this is the problem of they are not right people, they are not practicing properly. Because first in yoga is two things are main, yama and niyama. It is very important. But people are not covering that yama and niyama properly. They are not stopping the mind first. Patanjali says, yogas chitta vritti nirodhanaha. Means yoga means you have to stop your mind. The same Buddhism also saying the same thing. You have to stop your mind. Then what is happening? Then after we have to go on, we have to go to more practice of breathing and the Kundalini awakening way. Because when the Kundalini will rise, if you have mind, it will run through the mind. The all kind of disturbance will awake. The stress and the anxiety, many things are coming. Then you can witness in front of that desires, rising desires, you can witness that desires, it will come out slowly and it will be empty like a clear water later. But people cannot have that much of patience and that much of capacity to connect, to keep away the flow of desire. They will flush out along with this desire and totally destroy everything. So many, some kind of impotency, many problems are coming. Because the yoga chittavritti nirodha, the first yama niyama, I mean 8 limbs of Ashtanga Yoga, the yama niyama we have to teach properly and stop the mind, then only they can control the energy of Kundalini. First, we have to give capacity for that. Then, the Swadhisthana Chakra will will be free. Then only the brain, the block will little the block will be free. Then the Kundalini will start to run as one. Then it is helping to go to samadhi and the ecstasy of the enlightenment. But it is happening. Actually, the Kundalini is coming. Kundalini is Kamakala. Devi is chanting, pervaded as the universe are 64 Kamakala. Saying the George Woodruff, six serpent power, you can read that. So, what is happening is, when the Kundalini is rising from the Muladhara Chakra, it is desire force. By that desire, we took this body with the five senses to experience the Panjabhudas. I want to drink, I want to eat, I want to hear, I want to smell, I want to experience this universe, that is willpower. That's why I took this body. So, born baby is trying to experience maximum the five senses, always you can see, he is not thinking anything, he is in living in present. So, we need that kind. In 16, 1 to 6, who will enter in the kingdom of God? He got a child and who can be like the level of this child? Same thing. So, then the mind will be stopped. When the mind will stop, then the Swadhisthana will be little bit empty. Through that path.
But Kundalini Yoga does create a high vibration for the law of attraction, right?
Yeah, it is possible.
Yes. But it's not thinking. It's not from thinking it. It's from becoming magnetic.
Yeah. Yeah, the thought is a steering. Thought is like a steering of your car.
Yes.
Thought is manifesting actually.
Absolutely. Yeah. I've been teaching that for a long time. Do you use mantra? Do you chant in Kundalini Yoga? And what mantras do you? Yeah.
The importance of mantra. She's asking same that one. Manana Trayate Iti Mantra, saying like that. It is supporting to stop the wandering of the mind. The mantra can stop the wandering of the mind of the desire.
What's it called? All the mantras, you mean?
All the mantras. Supporting.
Do you have the mantra, this one, Ad Gure Name, Jugad Gure Name, Sat Gure Name, Siddhi Gure Deva Name, do you use that one?
No.
And how about?
Actually, the Srividya mantra have letters actually. This is not a meaningful, bigger stotra of this one. This is actually Bija mantras. It is some particular areas can stimulate. Example, hum, kareem, hum. Example, if you say hum, just say the mantra. Just pronounce the mantra. Hum. It will hit the muladhara, the base chakra. Hum, hum, hum. This is the same thing. This is used in example, Allahu, Allahu. Actually, in Sufism. Okay, my example, Om, Om, if you chant Om, what is happening? Just say the Om.
Om.
Same thing, but lightly. Lightly. The Hu mantra is hitting the Muladhara and rising the Kundalini. Example.
Yeah. Hum.
Yeah. The same thing in Gayatri mantra, it is Bhur Bhuvaswa. Bhur, Bhur. You just say Bhur Bhuvaswa. Gayatri mantra. Bhur. So, this particular, as per the development of Kundalini, particular areas to overcome some kind of levels, these mantras will help and guide the Kundalini proper way. It is supporting to rise the Kundalini and to guide through the proper path. Okay. So, actually what is happening, it is a complex thing, because when rising the Kundalini, to guide the Kundalini properly, we have to build a proper brain neuron network, neuron pathway. Otherwise, what will happen? You have some traumas in subconscious mind. Then when the rising of Kundalini, it will immediately start to run through that traumas. It will be awakened, that's traumas. Some kind of people have post-traumatic stress disorder, PTSD. If they will chant mantras, immediately the Kundalini will start to rise. The mantras are supporting. The mantras are actually pranayama, some kind of. If you chant mantra, the breathing style will be different. Everything is breathing. You know about that. Very good. Because you created some kind of special breathing techniques, I think like that. It is good. Okay. So, this breathing, the mantras are controlling the breathing. Some mantras can support the awaken easily. Running off of time, 40 minutes.
So, if you look, you can observe yourself, you can see the speed of the thought process decrease. It is just not just an imagination. You can feel the peace vibration and the thought process, speed of the thought process decrease. And this is the first level, I think. Proper move of Kundalini to the start process. So their subconscious mind, maybe our thought process in conscious mind, it will be still. But normally the subconscious mind
chatter continuously. The energy deals with the subconscious mind because our respiratory system, heartbeats, everything deals by the breath, and the breath is controlling by the subconscious mind. If you have the feel of sex or anger or something, the breathing pattern will be increased. In Sri Vidya, actually everything is connecting with the breathing. The difference of breathing pattern, as of the breathing pattern, system created, the rishis, sages created the mantras as for the breath. So everything is breathing. So by the emotion, normally we can control the breath, we can control the emotion, but it is not happening. Normally the emotions are coming and directing the breathing. According to normal people, they are suffering because by the outer images or outer the wrong neuron path, wrong development of neuron pathways, neurotransmitters, dopamine, oxytocin, serotonin, these kind of neurotransmitters acting wrongly, and everything is, the breathing changes will happen. That's why everything is going to space. Normally it is collapsing. Related to that, internal organs affecting the toxins. And so the main thing, the people ask for each and every time, minutes, breathing patterns are changing. What is the reason? Sometimes will more, sometimes will less. What is the reason? Why using doctors using stethoscope, chest? Because always it is changing. What is the reason of changing breathing? If you can see, observe yourself, as per the thought process, the emotions, always emotions are vary. It is related to desire. Actually, if you, we can say, stop desire, but is it not an easy thing? Because our desire is the living force, the reason of the life is desire. That's why we took this body and came here trying to experience what is the working force of our life is desire. Because I want to eat, drink and everything. What happening then? Then we normally, our thought process will stop, and the Swadhisthana will empty, the energy Kundalini will go to the Sushumna, and joining here with Shiva, making love with Shiva, this energy, male and female energy is making love here, so in Talu Chakra, and experiencing great happiness when you eat something special. What is happening? The thought process will stop, and the senses will be active, of the taste will be active. Then we can feel the joining of yoga inside. Then the thought process completely will stop. The energy and the senses will stimulate. We can experience that much of happiness. Actually, that ecstasy, that is samadhi actually. That is calling samadhi. How we can continue this samadhi? Normally it will be in 1 second. If you hear something, hear the music, it will be in 1 second. It will finish. We will come to this world of thought process. The breathing pattern will change. So, actually, Sri Vidya is more handling the desire part properly at the first stage. Not directly go to samadhi. Properly handling the desire part, and step by step, the path will open the Sushumna path properly, and helping to keep happening yoga here of the happiness, ecstasy. So that is samadhi. It is Trividya is for Trividya yoga is for that. Tantric yoga is for that. We can see next time we can discuss more. Okay. Thank you for your time.
Thank you so much. Thank you.